Well, I am deep into a project expanding my CRT shop. And this area that you see behind you right now is going to be going through some changes. First off, I've been installing insulation, as you can tell above me. There's new insulation anyway. And doing some electrical work. And we're going to put up walls and a ceiling in here. And this is all going to be great. For the future of retro tech and the CRT shop in general. So that's all really exciting. What I've got for you today is a flashback to an awesome CRT that is built into an automobile. And so why don't we sit back and check out more about a Buick Reatta from the 1990s when America really made some amazing automobiles. And we're going to check out a touch screen CRT that was standard in this car. All right, so let's jump over now. Check out this Reatta. Dad, I need to show you something really special here with my buddy.
All right, so you know we love amazing old school cars as well as CRTs here, but this is might be the ultimate
thing, the rarest CRT
right?
that's here. I mean, I don't know how many of these still exist, but
all right, let's get in here. I've got to see this.
So actually what I'll do is I have you go over to the other side.
Okay.
And lock it and just hop right in.
Oh my gosh. Right? Look at this thing. Ooh, so this is fun.
Door.
Now, I don't understand why I hear a high kilohertz. Oh my, look at this.
So behind the dash, it's just like a VFD that Buick and GM use in a lot of stuff. But right there, that is a 5-inch monochrome CRT.
So, oh my goodness.
Here I can turn on.
That's good. Yeah, that works. That's great.
There we go. So yeah, right now it's just doing that. Whenever you turn on the car, it'll do like a system check of everything that's in the car.
That's awesome. You even got the date right.
Yep.
No malfunctions.
Hooray!
We can make it home.
It's like, there's so much electronics in this car. It's like, that's the thing that always, when people pick these up, it's like, oh, what's going to be the gremlin I have to deal with? But yeah, here, so I'll show you. This is the homepage that it starts up with, and this gives you, you have like basic radio controls, basic climate control. I guess it defaults to giving you your MPG. Oh, there's Bob out there also here.
What's up, Bob? You want to get in?
Giving the grand tour. Yep, so.
You can open it.
Yeah, you can open it right up. I was just telling Steve, so this is the screen that it starts up with, and then it'll give you the date on the bottom. You can have like personal reminders that pop up, and you can program in like anniversary dates or birthdays, and
dude,
just like
my wife would never be pissed at me again.
Or it's like, I'm going to the grocery store, like you can have it to tell you pick up milk or something like that. And then I'll give you like your just average MPG, basic climate controls here. On the climate page, it's like all the controls for
turning awesome.
On. The fan will animate based off height, how fast you put the fan.
Oh, I love that.
Like all the radio controls
cool.
are right here.
So it's really deep. Like I bet people sit here and didn't know what the heck they were doing pressing buttons back in the day.
We're in this parking garage. I doubt we're going to get any reception at all.
Oh, but no, yeah, no, like, right?
Yeah, it's just crackly right now. But
that's okay. We'll get copyright claimed if anything comes on anyway.
Exactly. I love this little trick. This eject button right here ejects the cassette
door. Oh, no. Oh, my gosh.
Right here, you got
This is the most unbelievable vehicle ever, man.
Right here on the gauge screen. So this is usually what I leave it on when driving around and everything. And
oh, my
this
gosh.
Is real
Those
time.
RPMs, yeah.
Yeah, just all real time.
It gives you the voltage
yeah,
and
yeah.
your pressure on your oil. Unbelievable.
Oh, yeah. and then your coolant temperature and everything. Because, like, Buick never gave gauges in any of the... Because it's like, old people don't want to look at needles, and they're going to think, oh, why is my temperature gauge at halfway?
Yeah, right.
On there? Is my car broken? So, but yeah, you get full gauges in here on the screen. On the options menu, there's a trip computer where you can enter in... Like, say, I know my destination is going to be, like, I don't know, 15 miles away. You punch that in, and then it'll give you, like, an estimated time of arrival based off of, like, your average time that you've driven around on and everything. Yeah, here's the, like, reminder section where you can, like, view and... I don't think I have anything in there.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
And then,
we'll get over there and then the... Okay.
And then,
okay.
Like, this is all.
Yeah. Yeah.
In the diagnostic section, you can even it'll give you an example of say, if your brake fluid's low, you'll get like a C screen. Something pops up on the C diagnostic center pops up. I can actually. So yeah, that thing will pop up, and this will pop up on here saying, "Oh, you need brake fluid," or even we'll do like. When your washer fluid's low, it gives you this animation on the screen.
That's so crazy. Well, I also noticed, like, you can tell, it's got the tube behind this overlay.
Yeah, yep.
And if you look really close, which I'll show you on the screen, you can see little dots that's using to, you know, tell where you're obviously touching. And then if you look at, like, the design of it, you can see how it's got, like, the CRT set up easily. You can go in here, because it's monochrome, it doesn't need a... Since it's monochrome, it doesn't need to be a very deep tube for sharpness or anything.
This entire thing's a module, and it does go back, I think, about like yay or so back there. I know the tubes themselves in this car are made by Zenith.
Okay.
I don't quote me on this, but I believe that they're also like the same tubes that they would use in some like aircraft.
Not heads-up displays,
but
like little monitor things on the. It's probably doing the same kind of stuff on planes.
Exactly.
Well, very cool, man.
Yeah. Oh, and then also I got pop-up headlights as well, and you always need pop-up headlights.
That's
another reason why I bought the car.
CRTs, pop-up headlights. What the heck happened to our society? We've gotten so bad, right, man? So that is Steve, and I got to give a special shout out to Steve because it was really great of him to show me the Buick Reatta, and he actually did a more detailed video on his own channel. I will link that video right up here, and I'm gonna pin a comment with his channel right below, and I'll also add it to the description of this video because you really should check out his channel. He has a lot of great CRTs. And also, if you have ever been to the Retro World Expo and you've seen this amazing video wall set up, Steve's the one who sets it all up. And so I also have a cool video where Steve and I and some other amazing people from the retro scene got together and checked out his video wall kind of in depth. So we'll have another video coming soon about that, but that's about it on this Buick Reatta. I really love seeing stuff like this, especially when it gets when something like this gets in the hands of a collector and somebody who's really going to take care of it, and getting a chance to see it is awesome. So thank you as always, Steve, for being so hospitable every time I'm in Connecticut. If you ever go to Retro World, make sure you stop by and say hey to Steve and check out his video wall. And I'll see you guys next time with some more retro content.